over 300 Indian students are facing deportation from Britain. This after the UK's border agency revoked the London Metropolitan University's license to admit students from non-European Union countries. As the hapless students stare at an uncertain future, the Indian government has to wash their hands of this case.
Then suddenly I get this news that London Metropolitan has no license to continue to the for the international students, and it just came a big shock to me. You know, I couldn't believe what London Metropolitan is doing.
So I must say that students are facing a lot of difficulties, so I don't think so a student will just tolerate this thing, and there will be a great crisis ahead of.
My major concern is a degree, whether we will get a degree at the end of the day, because we have spent something around 13 lakh to 20 lakh rupees coming here.
Threat of deportation now looms large over 300 Indian students in London. A centrally located London Metropolitan University has been stripped of its right to sponsor non-European Union students. Caught in its unprecedented crisis, students have no idea of what's in store for them.
Now no international students won't be allowed to study over there, not even the current students, not even the new students which are gonna enroll this year. So which is like a bit shocking news, and Indian embassy should talk about this reasons that they should allow the Indian, like, talk to London government.
The cancellation of the university's license comes in the wake of investigation by the border agency. The investigation had revealed that many students did not have a valid visa, and some of them had limited English abilities, a must-have for entry into the UK.
If the decision that they have been taken, that the license has been revoked, it will have definitely a negative impact on the current international students.
The students have been given a 90-day deadline to seek transfer to other universities. If they fail to seek transfer, the students shall face deportation. Add on the cumbersome visa process, another reason for their suffering. The university representatives, however, want to fight this revocation.
The university has been working with the UK Border Agency in recent weeks over a number of issues. We were very surprised by the outcome to this, because we know what a huge effect that has over thousands of students, and indeed starts to cast some questions about higher education in the whole UK system.
About the UKBA thing, we can't say anything. We know what they have, like policies and regulations, but yes, their screenings are very, very strict and tight.
Just as the Indian students were looking up to the Indian government to take up this issue, the government has decided to wash their hands off this problem, dashing their hopes.
That students should be less gullible. Students should take care before they admit themselves to any institution. But in fact, they knew very well, some of them, that those institutions were actually a sort of gateway to get a permit to work in those countries.
This is the first time in Britain that a university's license to teach foreign students has been revoked by the UK Border Agency. There is a very strong feeling amongst the foreign student community here that Britain is not very keen on having them in their country. They also feel that this decision is more to do with government's target of curtailing immigration by 2015 than any else. But the students have decided that they are starting a campaign to protest against UKBA's decision to revoke the license of London Metropolitan University to teach them, which has put their futures on stake. Lavina Tandon for Headlines Today from London.